joined millions to private investors in 2007. Scannell tells the story tonight at 7:30, but now on RTE One, Shortland Street.
You really think I'm like you?
Yeah, a much younger me, but I think I've seen you a bit more.
What happened with you and Jay?
We kissed.
Sorry?
I kissed Jay.
Your girlfriend? She tried to get it on with mine.
One kiss, one single kiss, and Felicia kissed me.
For crying out loud, start talking. I thought I was way down on your list tonight.
No, not way down. Second.
So, how'd it go with Scarlett?
That's a work in progress.
Mm-hmm. Talking or silent treatment?
Talking, thank goodness. It's going to take some time.
Well, don't let me stop you. I can be left hanging. I've had plenty of practice.
Okay. This is a bad time.
Wait! Can't you take a joke?
Not anymore.
Felicia's not hurt then. Just a sprained ankle. And some wounded pride, I guess. Mike bandaged up her leg, so she's home now.
What were you thinking?
What?
Leading her on like that. She's a young, confused girl.
Well, hang on. You think that the kiss was my fault?
The poor girl has had a crush on you for weeks. All the questions, the dancing
session. Babe, are you serious?
You knew exactly what was going on and you liked it, admit it.
You honestly believe that I would get my kicks out of flirting with some young girl?
Only you can answer that. So do you want a beer or something?
No, thanks.
Australian refuses beer. Yeah, right.
No, I've already had the one. Still got to drive home.
Stay here.
Scarlett's on her own.
She's nearly 17. I think she can make her own breakfast. You haven't told her yet, have you?
Well, there's no rush, is there?
Craig.
I'm just waiting for the right moment. She's still processing.
Well, if you think I'm just going to sneak around, waiting for you to turn up here whenever you feel like
come
it.
Come on. Look, who you and Scarlett were close. They still are.
How long are you going to wait?
Look, this is a big thing, Sarah. I'm trying to protect her.
From what? The truth?
No, of course not. Look, we're together, okay? I just don't want to rub anyone's nose in it.
I feel like the mistress.
Well, you're not. For long. I promise.
Okay. Well, until we're an official couple, complete with public displays of affection, you're not coming near my bedroom. Cup of tea, biscuit before you go.
Okay. That's the way you want it?
No, wait. Who am I kidding?
Nice kick. What's your name?
Peter Flynn.
Sounds like a real soccer player name. Maybe you'll play professionally one day. Would you like that?
His old man sure would.
I bet.
You'll keep practicing, don't you, mate?
Yeah.
Thanks for that.
Pleasure.
Have you just moved to the area?
No.
Oh, it's just I've noticed you here the last few days.
I often stop for a coffee here, on my break or on my way to work. They're at a lovely age, aren't they? So much energy.
They sleep through the night. I'm happy. Need my 8 hours.
Sounds like me.
Don't get me wrong. I love them as babies, but all that getting up 2-3 times a night, forget it.
You men don't know the half of it. You've got it easy.
Is that right? Good work, mate. Now give Amber a go, eh?
Hope you got enough beauty sleep, Dr. Warner, we got today.
Handsome and talented, it never ends.
I need to make some adjustments.
Just so long as Brenda's still on the team.
I've given you Carol instead. Do you remember Carol? 15 years in the game, knows what you want before you ask for it, Carol.
Yeah, but still.
Everyone's dying to assist you. I almost had to draw straws.
Scott's a golfing legend. Hell, if I wasn't the scalpel, I'd want to be there too.
Oh, I think the surgeon is the legend. And don't worry, your precious Brenda will be there.
Excuse me, could I have my theatre schedule, please?
Sure.
Talk about the B team.
Pardon?
It is a bit thin.
You've got a full team, including the nursing manager. Unless you're suggesting my work is substandard?
No.
Good. I should hope not.
Don't worry, May. You're still a legend to me.
Have you always lived in Ferndale?
Yeah, mostly. We moved here when I was about Pete's age. Cambridge before that.
Beautiful country around there.
Yeah, great place to grow up.
Part of a big farming family?
No, it's just me. No brothers and sisters.
Must have been out lonely for you.
Nah, great parents. Spoiled me rotten.
We all spoil our children.
Yeah, I was adopted, so extra spoiled.
Really? I often wondered if I was adopted, if I'd look for my birth parents. Did you? I hope you don't mind me asking.
I thought about it when I was about 14, I think. You know, it's like it's all doom and gloom then, isn't it? Pimples, braces, my parents don't understand me, all that. But I grew out of it. What happened?
He crashed right into the pole.
Oh, mate, what have you done?
My head.
Don't worry, love. Just apply pressure.
I better get him home.
No, I work up at Shortland Street, just up the road. We'll get him looked at there. All
right, come on, mate. You're all right.
If I made you some toast, would you forgive me?
I feel like cereal.
Why, will you cut me a break here, please? I didn't do anything wrong.
You said you needed forgiving.
Yes, for not handling things well with Etty. For being naive, yes, I admit that. But just a little bit of backup now wouldn't go amiss. Toast, Etty?
No, thanks.
Look, there's probably a lot of things going through your mind right now, but if we can sit down and talk about it, we can sort it out.
I'm good. Hey, Kaz, it's Etty. Yeah, I'm good. Is Auntie Tahana there? All right, well, can you tell her to give me a call when she gets back? It's urgent. Cheers, bye. See ya.
Why are you calling her?
And what's so urgent?
You need a place to stay.
No, Etty, you have a home here.
No, not anymore. Well, I'm thinking...